Good afternoon, everyone. Please be seated. On behalf of WVU Tech, I welcome you to the 123rd commencement celebration of our university. I am Dr. Cortney Barco, Chair of the Faculty Assembly. To begin today's celebration, please stand for our national anthem, sung by Professor Hillary Parcell, Chair of WVU School of Nursing, Beckley Campus.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the pale
Thank you, Professor Parcell. Please be seated. I would now like to introduce the platform guests, starting with Dr. Asad Davari, the WVU Tech Marshal, Dr. Cynthia Hall, Chair of the WVU Tech Academic Awards Committee, Dr. Tamara Floyd Smith, Dean of the Leonard C. Nelson College of Engineering and Sciences, Dr. Scott Fleming, Dean of the College of Business, Humanities, and Social Sciences, Professor Hillary Parcell, Chair of the WVU School of Nursing, Beckley Campus, and Dr. T. Ramon Stewart, WVU Tech President. We would also like to recognize Paul Maddox, Chair of the Institutional Board of Visitors and member of the WVU Board of Governors and the Tech Golden Bear Alumni Association, and Mike Fry, President of the Tech Golden Bear Alumni Association. We would also like to recognize our community partner, Dr. Bonnie Copenhaver, President of New River Community and Technical College. And a special thanks to our ASL interpreter, Alice Almond, and video support from Cucumber and Company for their assistance with today's ceremony. Today, we would also like to recognize a group of individuals who are vital to graduation. Would all our faculty and staff please stand and be recognized for your hard work and for helping our students on their journey to this important milestone. Thank you, you may be seated. Also, we extend a special thanks to the Commencement Committee and everyone who makes this important event possible. It is my honor to serve as your Faculty Assembly Chair. On behalf of the faculty, your professors at WVU Tech, I want to congratulate you on your accomplishment today, graduating from college. Your professors who have been with you throughout your journey are celebrating with you today. Throughout your years of college at WVU Tech, you may have heard a professor or two tell you that grades are not given, they are earned. If you ever took a class with me, you likely heard me say that. I tell my students this because I want them to understand the value of doing hard work to earn their rewards in life. I think of hard work as work that is physically and or mentally demanding. Earning a good grade in a college course is something that students must work hard to achieve. For students, earning the grade of an A in a college class indicates that a student has worked hard to far exceed the professor's expectations. That student has done the work necessary to be rewarded with that grade of an A. Now, you may initially think of rewards you can earn after college graduation as things that you can see and touch, such as your first house, a new car, or that motorcycle you've had your eye on. None of these things, however, will just be given to you. All of these things are rewards you must earn by putting in genuine effort, long hours, and dedication to your careers so that you have the money to buy these rewards. Doing hard work is important. It shows the people around you that you care about what you do and that you will make sacrifices to earn the rewards that are important to you. Just as hard work is important in life, so too is good work. I like to think of good work as the things we do in our lives because they are morally and ethically the right things to do. And we are rewarded for our good work in life too, maybe even more so than for our hard work. You can do good work in your lives by treating everyone fairly and equally. You can do the good work of making the people around you feel like they are appreciated and that they matter. And while it's true that sometimes people in this life will make you feel angry, invisible, or lesser than others, and when you encounter these people, you should always remember your worth. But you can do the good work of treating even these people with kindness and understanding, just as you would want to be treated. In doing the good work of living a life of honesty and integrity, you will be rewarded greatly. You will be rewarded by having people come to you because they trust you, respect you, rely on you, and know that they can come to you and not be judged or dismissed. Doing good work allows others to see the goodness that lies within you. These rewards for doing good work are not ones you can always see or touch, but they matter greatly and are rewards that you can carry with you for the rest of your lives. The rewards that you earn in this life, either from hard work or good work, don't always come quickly or easily or exactly when you want them to. But that's okay. Some of the best rewards in life take time to earn. They will come. I speak today from personal experience, as one of the greatest rewards that I've earned in my life came from a combination of hard work and good work. That reward is my career as an English professor at WVU Tech and the students who I have the pleasure of teaching and getting to know here. My career rewards me with first-generation college students who work hard to be the first person in their families to earn a college degree, international students who work hard to write me lots of essays in English, and graduating college seniors who will go out into the workforce and do the hard work and the good work that will make WVU Tech proud. For all our graduates today, I hope that your hard work and your good work rewards you with fulfilling lives and careers that bring you joy, pride, and give you the opportunity to help others and treat everyone with kindness and respect. Once again, congratulations to our graduating class of 2023. please continue to make your professors proud. Now, please join me in welcoming Mauro Maminta, president of the WVU Tech Student Government Association, who will bring greetings on behalf of the SGA.
Before I start this, I have a question for all my fellow graduates. Are you ready, kids? I can't hear you. You guys, okay, sure, we'll do it. Good afternoon, friends and family, faculty and staff, esteemed guests, alumni, and to you, the graduating class of 2023. It's finally that time. After all of that work, struggle, tears, nights in the library where I'd fall asleep under the study room tables, actual blood being taken from me by my professors for a lab, and almost being caught on fire by my lab partner, Carley, all I have to say is wow. What even was that? I ask what even was that because I'm not too sure how to explain all that happened in my time at Tech, since everything defied any preconception I had of college. Of course, I remember the contents of my classes, like how the sassafras tree smells like Fruit Loops, or that some turtles can breathe through their butts. But college is so much more than what is learned in the classroom. College to me was walking into a familiar library or classroom with people who I shared a common goal with. Even if we didn't share the same major, I shared conversations with people over a cup of coffee that had way too much espresso. That was one part of college, but what else happened? While we've been at Tech, a lot has happened in the world, guys. And it was frightening watching it occur at times. And honestly, it felt like many things were beyond our control. However, you defied the world's expectations and continue to see how things could be in spite of the way that it is. Every day, the school defied my expectations of what college would be. When I was a freshman, I didn't think I'd be the SGA president, giving a speech at graduation and failing to imagine everyone here in their underwear. I didn't think there'd be such a great academic challenge given by my professors that would also accompany it with great compassion and great understanding. I didn't think I'd make some of the best relationships in my life with both students and staff who I see here today. No. This was the part of the degree that we don't list in prerequisites or learning outcomes, but it is the part of my education that I treasure more than anything. So, my fellow graduates, I have but one favor to ask of you all. Keep defying expectations. Defy the wrongs of the world because you are a force of good. Defy the people who say you can't, and especially, defy the expectations you hold on yourselves. Thank you, Tech, and thank you, my friends, in the class of 2023.
Thank you, Mauro. Now I would like to introduce Dr. Cynthia Hall. She's here to confer the Presidential Leadership Awards on behalf of the WVU Tech Academic Awards Committee.
Like Dr. Barco said, my name is Dr. Cynthia Hall. I'm an associate professor of psychology, and I represent the Academic Awards Committee, a faculty panel privileged with bestowing one of Tech's most prestigious awards, the Leonard C. Nelson Presidential Leadership Award. This award, established in 1978, has historically been awarded to one student from each of our three colleges. This award is bestowed on students who not only have achieved academic excellence, but also have demonstrated distinctive representation of the college and university in local, state, regional, and national forums. In addition, these three leaders have demonstrated extensive involvement in both campus and community activities. These students are the ones who have gone above and beyond the norm to impact their studies, WVU Tech, and the surrounding communities. Candidates for this award must be nominated, and they complete a detailed application packet. The Academic Awards Committee, made up of four voting faculty and non-voting representatives from the Division of Student Life, and three student representatives, reviews those packets and determines the award recipient from each college. The candidates made our choice extremely difficult, as they have all distinguished themselves and have given so much time and help to WVU Tech, our academic programs, clubs, and campus community would not be what it is today without your energy, ingenuity, and contribution. I'd like us all to give the nominees and candidates for this award and our outstanding graduates a round of applause and gratitude for their contributions to our campus community. I am pleased to introduce to you our first awardee, the recipient of the Presidential Leadership Award from the College of Business, Humanities, and Social Sciences. The 2023 recipient is Mackenzie Siersma. Mackenzie, please approach the stage. Mackenzie majors in criminal justice with minors in forensic investigation and psychology and graduates today summa cum laude. Mackenzie is a member of the softball team and also volunteered her time to teach softball camps at Shady Spring High School. She is active in the Criminal Justice Association, serving as vice president and president, and active in the Forensic Science Club. She has participated in community service activities, such as working for the food pantry for North Holland Reformed Church and the MLK Day of Service. It is with great pleasure that I welcome Kenzie as a well-deserving recipient of this year's Presidential Leadership Award in the College of Business, Humanities, and Social Sciences. Congratulations, Kenzie.
So first off, thank you, Dr. Hall, and all the panelists for that. Also, congratulations. College is hard, and I know many of you had other priorities on top of school, which included jobs, athletics, and other personal responsibilities, which definitely made it hard even on top of college. So I just want to say that I'm proud of you all for making it work and for getting to this point in your lives. Through the sleepless nights, the countless hours in the library, the stress of getting papers turned in on time, and everything in between, you did it. Thank you to all the professors and Tech staff who have been by our sides rooting us for us every step of the way. All of you have played an important part in my life as well as many others here today. Thank you to all the parents, the guardians, and all the friends who have come here to support everyone here. We wouldn't be who we are without you. I personally wanted to thank my parents, my sister, my softball team, and my coaches who have been there for me through everything and pushed me to be a better person. Nice, okay. So I'm also extremely thankful for each and every one of you. Whether we shared a conversation or just simply a wave or a smile in the hallway or along the road or whatever, I'm appreciative of you. Being roughly 9+ hours away from home hasn't been easy. I miss things that were very important to me as well as other people that would be. And so I miss funerals, family events, birthdays, and overall my family and friends. You have all been extremely welcoming and supportive of not only me, but everyone else in this room, especially for those who are in the same situation as I am, being far away from home. Whether you know it or not, you have made a positive difference in my life. I've made friends I know I'll be able to count on forever. You have all made West Virginia Tech a home away from home for the past 4 years. I remember the first day I moved into college, my freshman year. My parents and my sister were there helping me unload all my stuff I packed to make my dorm a new home for a while. I clearly remember my dad mentioning to have fun, enjoy the time while you can, because it goes by fast. So I leave you with this. Never take a day you have here on earth for granted. Enjoy all the laughter you have with your friends and family, and give yourself grace when you're struggling. Make sure to remind those around you that you love them and thank them for their support. Make sure to do this. Do whatever you do, make sure you're happy, and and hopefully no one dims your light in this world, because you're a lot more important than anyone thinks you are. Have confidence in yourself as you go out today, because you are one of a kind and truly a masterpiece in every way imaginable. Have the courage to follow your heart and trust in it. Life sometimes is not easy and will throw every curveball up its sleeve at you as you leave here today. It's on how you respond and move forward. I'm fully confident that each and every one of you will overcome every battle you will face. You are worthy and capable of following your dreams and making a positive impact in people's lives. I will continue to pray for all your successes and future plans that God has in store for you, because none of this would happen without him. I can't wait to see you all grow as we leave here today. So once again, congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you, Kinsey. Next, I would like to invite our recipient from the Leonard C. Nelson College of Engineering Sciences to the stage, Valentino Abondano Perdomo. Valentina, please join me on stage. Valentina graduated summa cum laude in December with majors in chemistry and psychology. She was the founder of the Chemistry Club, member of the American Chemical Association, and the Green Bandana Initiative. Valentina completed internships at Momentum and CTY by John Hopkins. Valentina was a member of the volleyball team. She received the Student Academic Excellence Award 4 years in a row. She served as a tutor in our Student Success Center, was a chemistry lab assistant and teaching assistant for introductory chemistry, was an orientation leader, and completed independent research in psychology's rodent laboratory and in chemistry. She presented her original research in chemistry at Undergraduate Research Day at the Capitol in Charleston, West Virginia, and is a published author. Following her graduation in December, Valentina was hired as an assistant scientist at Thermo Fisher Scientific. I am honored to present this award to Ms. Valentina Abondano Perdomo. Congratulations, Valentina.
Thanks, Dr. Hall. Welcome once again to the 2023 Commencement. Thank you to everyone that came today to celebrate and congratulate the 2023 graduates. To the graduates, today marks the end of your college era. The last 4 years were almost stress-free, if we don't count the lack of sleep and caffeine fixation. The rush and excitement we felt when we started is the same we feel now, with an extra of uncertainty what comes next and nostalgia for what we're leaving behind. 5 months ago, I was at Susanne's office, as usual, laying down, hugging the big bear, eating all her snacks, while asking her what comes now. Funny to think how settling for one option feels like the biggest commitment, but not making up your mind, it's even worse. Apparently, I have a thing for states that begin with W, and Wyoming was out of the place, so Wisconsin seemed like the right place to begin my career. It wasn't easy to start from zero at a new place with a new job in the middle of winter. They don't tell you in the job offer all the extra challenges you'll be facing besides your job description, like learning the penguin walk to avoid slips on ice, learning how to live with strangers, setting up your 401k, and realizing that 4 inches of snow is actually nothing compared to 7 inches that will cover your car. But beyond that gloomy view, wearing multiple layers and juggling a new routine, the call will give you a chance to slow down and grasp your new reality. Solitude will give you and help you take all this that we took for granted when we were focusing on the goal and not exactly on the path. Therefore, today I ask you all to take a deep breath, look around, and realize that the thing you've been desiring for so long is finally here. All the efforts, sacrifices, bumps on the road, achievements, dedication, and discipline has paid off. As you thank your family, friends, faculty members, and administrators, remember to thank yourself. Only you know how hard you've worked for this and how much you have overcome. So go ahead and give yourself that pat on the back. Remember to stop occasionally and see how far you've come. Go to memory lane and appreciate the mistakes and successes you had during these last years. Realize how your professors slowly became your allies, how your teammates became your family, and the classmates that you share a room with now might be one phone call away. Hesitation will come, where you will wonder if you're adulting the right way. You will realize that we're all in the same boat, craving greatness and success, but homesick of the people and places we have seen and left behind. Don't be afraid to ask for help, to take a pause, catch a break, and move forward. The things will slowly fall into place, and you will start getting a sense of it. Home is no longer a place, but a feeling of safety that comes from the people that made us feel loved, comfortable, and happy. And when feeling at ease, we'll cherish the memories we had and seek for the people we love. To the graduates that will move away from home for the first time, congratulations on this new adventure. Can't emphasize enough how much you're going to grow, learn, and enjoy being on your own, facing new challenges. Nevertheless, hold your family tight, because you never know when the last time would be. And do not forget your roots that will keep you grounded wherever you go. To my foreigner graduates, congratulations on moving abroad, starting a life by yourselves, and accomplishing what you came for and even more. Now, wherever life takes you, in or outside the States, you will call West Virginia a part of that home. To all my friends, family, and mentors I found at WVU Tech, I appreciate all the times I felt scared and life looked uncertain and all you stood by me. Change is not always easy, but with my sense of humor and sarcasm, I've made the best out of it. Last, to my dearest friend Emily, no olvides lo orgullosos que nuestros papás están. Thanks.
Thank you, Valentina. Our final awardee today is from the WVU School of Nursing Beckley campus. It is with great pleasure that I announce Carley Knuckles as the 2023 Presidential Leadership Award recipient. Carley, please join us on stage. Carley is graduating magna cum laude. Carley is founder and president of Active Minds, a mental health and suicide prevention organization, and a previous member of the Student Nursing Association. She has previously received awards for Outstanding Student Leader 2022-2021 and Student Leader of the Year 21-22. Carley has completed service learning projects in mental health for the senior population and in skin cancer awareness. She has completed research projects in substance use prevention. Upon graduation, she will have completed more than 900 clinical nursing hours and more than 100 volunteer hours. She has certifications in mental health first aid, Narcan administration, oral health certification, transgender health certification, domestic violence prevention, and many others. Carley has also served as a nurse extern at Beckley Appalachian Regional Hospital. Congratulations, Carley.
OMG. Look at us. Who would have thought? Not me, but here we are. Thank you guys. Again, my name is Carly Knuckles. It is such an honor to speak in front of all the beautiful families, faculty, staff, and most importantly, in front of all my beautiful friends here today. For those who may not know me very well, you may remember me as the girl that was throwing stress balls at you in the library, the girl with the funky pants and the coffee 24/7, the nursing student testing your pee in the clinic, and most recently, the nursing student most likely to panic an emergency. Or maybe I'm that girl that you just held the door open for. I remember the people that opened the first doors here for me at WVU Tech. These people are the ones that I felt truly believed in me and my ability and empowered me to help the community and even the world. These women showed me my potential. These women helped me grow to be a star. These women really ultimately saved me. I know, all that from a door. But it really sets a precedent for how I'm gonna live my life when I leave here today. So I want to relay my mantra with you. So be that positive force. Be proactive and don't only believe in the abilities of yourself, but believe in the abilities of others. And if you remember anything that I say here today, it's okay to not be okay, to not understand, to not be perfect, to have no idea what you're doing, because newsflash, we're young, 21, 22, 23, 35, we're young. I don't think we're supposed to know, but I do know as long as we wake up every single day making an effort to grow and to empower, I think that we will be okay. It's been real, it's been fun, but it ain't been real fun. Congratulations, guys, we did it, and I'm so proud of each and every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Carly. All right, everyone, please join me in giving one more round of applause to our Presidential Award leaders.
Thank you, Dr. Hall. Graduates and guests, please welcome our academic deans for the presentation of candidates for degrees. I would like to invite Dean Tamara Floyd Smith to the podium.
The moment you've all been waiting for. President Stewart, I have the privilege of presenting the undergraduate candidates from the Leonard C. Nelson College of Engineering and Sciences. These candidates have been recommended by the faculty, having completed all requirements for their Bachelor of Science degrees in biology, chemical engineering, chemistry, computer science, construction management, civil engineering, computer engineering, engineering technology, information systems, mathematics, and mechanical engineering. Woo! Will all the candidates please rise and come forward to receive your degrees?
Ellie Baker. Logan Cole Bauer. Kayla Lauren Elizabeth Kaufman. Megan Ashley Kozor. McCall Alexa Daniel. Elijah J. Fema. Colton Honecker. Ashton B. Hudson. Braden Jett. Nicole Kester. Mario Miguel Barquero Maminta. Cortney Elizabeth Miles. Taylor Rochelle Sexton. Samuel David Shrewsbury. Kaylee Stover. Kylie Elizabeth Thompson. Avery Torres. Cody James Walker. Alexis Dawn Wood. Isaiah Casto. Kelly Mills. Emily De Los Angeles Henry Santa Maria. Valentina Abondano Perdomo. Brendan Blake. Tyler Kibler. Anand Mohatra. Garrett Hammett. Aaron Harmon. Jason Lusk. Andrea Malinkovich. Isaiah Leota Smirkatsky. Hunter Tolliver. Yeah. Nicholas Dalton Anderson. Carmen Camino Falcon. Allison Facemeyer. Shane Matthew Griffith. Andrew Tracy Harmon. Nathan Morton. Dylan Casey Repass. Oleg Torshin. Colton Gage Turner. Chase Preston Higginbotham. Aiden S. Jones. Caleb A. Lamb. Chad Jonathan Booth. Yvonne Martinez. Tyron Sean Musser. Carson Piercy Shannon. Emily O'Neill Lumaster. Logan Christopher Pennington. Jonathan Bill. Michael Blessent. Christiana DePisson. Glacio Lopez McDonald. Elizabeth Zumong Lowe. Noah Questenberry. Caitlin Taylor. Daniel R. Vance. Jonathan Alton Wood. Chris Grussi. Daniel McCauley. Elijah William Buckland. Jason Constable. Andrea Segovia Fernandez. Jacob Earl Halterman. Paul Islava Evian. Nicholas Junkins. Eugenie Marcelli. Hayden Mathers. Tanner Myers. Josue Nunez. Abdurrahman Khalad Sharir Rabia. Jonathan Tyler Wilson.
I would now like to invite Dean Scott Fleming to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Smith. President Stewart, I have the privilege of presenting the undergraduate candidates from the College of Business, Humanities, and Social Sciences. These candidates have been recommended by the faculty, having completed requirements for their Bachelor of Science degree in Accounting, Adventure Recreation Management, Athletic Coaching Education, Aviation Management, Business Management, Criminal Justice, Forensic Investigation, Health Services Administration, History and Government, Psychology, Public Service Administration, Regents Bachelor of Arts, and Sports Management. I also have the privilege of presenting the candidates from the Associate of Applied Science degrees in Hospitality Culinary from WU Potomac State College. These candidates pursued this degree program here at WU Tech. The candidates have been recommended by the faculty, having completed all requirements for their Associate of Applied Science degrees in Hospitality Culinary program. Will all candidates please rise and come forward to receive your degree?
Rachel Elizabeth Daniel. Grant Edward Davis. Derek Landis. Regan Ann Lively. Trevor James Morrison. Amanda Laura Wiles. Miles Bolin. Jacob Clock. Amir Hieronymus. Indrick S. Albert. Anthony Joseph Connie the Third. Caitlin Deborah Dorsey. Louis Jaimes. Parker Lee Maynard. Lane Rhodes. Jonathan Toro Misa. Alexis Zelensky. Savannah Mackenzie Bailey. Cheyenne Brooke Keys. Keandre King. Carlene Louise McClung. Connor Isaac Pack. Mackenzie Siersma. Jacob Roger Thomas. Kaylee Madison Hatfield. Kevin Aaron Minton. Matthew Smith. Brianna Stevenson. Aiko Dana Francisco. Samantha Nicole Holbrook. Jordan Brooke Rutherford. Vince Ryan Treadway. Edward Lee Reedy. Jared Scott. Mason Amaya Black. Brianna N. Blake. Brianna Coley. Kimberly Ray Crane. Kalia Creasy. Sydney Cross. Sydney Alexis Graham. Nathan Henshu. Ashley Lingerfeld. Gabriel Marie Piles. Shanna Marie Rourke. Kaylin Victoria Sizemore. Lucas Smith. Bethany Stover. Adam Themius. Micah Price. Raymond Black. Jacinda Chapman. Sean Dakota Farley. James Andrew Gerald. Jane K. Pinnock Smith. Andrea Kelly Shuck. Ramon Luis Perez Valenzuela. Shamil Walton. Matthew Xavier King. Ryan Miller. Jody Pallant. Kobe Roselle. Eddie Tordoff. Isaac Wengert. Haley Booth.
As the students take their seats, I would like to invite Professor Hillary Parcell to the podium.
President Stewart, I have the privilege of presenting the candidates for the WVU School of Nursing Beckley campus. These candidates have been recommended by the faculty, have completed all requirements for their Bachelor of Science degrees in nursing. Will all candidates please rise and come forward to receive your degrees?
Thank you. Britton Brianna Barley. Kayla Nicole Blankenship. Mackenzie Faith Boggs. Elijah C. Brown. Ted Cancel. Brooklyn Cook. Tristan Philip Coots. Sabra Grace Feather. Alexander Douglas Fennell. Aaron McKenna Gosnell. Emily K. Gullion. Danielle Elizabeth Hansard. Robert Edward Harris. Cortney Ann Kincaid. Carley Ann Knuckles. Emma Elizabeth Leach. Haley Dawn McGraw. Madison Meadows. Sierra Mullahan. Sydney Jean Moneypenny. Elizabeth Grace Morgan. Shanae Morgan. Sydney Morton. Kaylee Jo Nicholson. Teresa Orndorf. Bethany T. Pittman. Evan Brady Priest. Michaela Smith. Olivia Jane Steer. Alyssa Lane Taylor. Lucas R. Thompson. Brady L. Vance. Jonathan Chance Withrow. Christina Madison Worley.
Congratulations again to all of our graduates. Please be seated. It is now my honor to invite our president, Dr. T. Ramon Stewart, to confer degrees and provide remarks.
Well, good afternoon. Upon the recommendation of the chair, graduates, please stand. Upon the recommendation of the chair of the faculty assembly and approval of the deans and faculty of West Virginia University Institute of Technology, and on behalf of the West Virginia Higher Education Policy Commission, by virtue of the authority vested in me, I am pleased to confer upon each of you the appropriate degree with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities attendant thereto. Graduates, you may move your tassel. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for the graduates of the class of 2023. Graduates, you may be seated. I want to spend a few moments with you to provide a few comments to this graduating class. And first, I'd be remiss without recognizing my predecessor, Carolyn Long, who honestly led each one of you to this particular point. I'm so thankful to have her guidance and tutelage, and I applaud her for what she did to ensure that West Virginia University Institute of Technology gave you the opportunity to get your degree. And to the world-renowned, dedicated, and talented faculty and staff here at WVU Tech, I say thank you for what you did to ensure that these individuals got the education that they need to be prepared to go forward. And to the family and friends of our graduates, see, I know that many of you have sacrificed blood. You provided some sweat, and there have been many, many lonely nights on your knees, and you shed tears. And so, graduates, if you would, please rise to your feet and look up in the seats and find that loved one, those family, and that friend that got you here today, and give them a round of applause. Graduates, see, graduates, there could be no you without them, and so it's appropriate because those are part of the reason that you made it. See, some of you may think that you started from the bottom, but now you're here. We got 17 different countries represented, and we actually just minted 35 and a half new nurses today. Some of you are first-generation college students, and some of you are second-generation Golden Bears. But what all of you are is the best of tech. See, I know you're the best of tech because you survived the pandemic. Well, not only did you survive, you thrived during the pandemic. You climbed steep hills in Beckley, West Virginia, and you made those late-night runs to Cookout, Taco Bell, and Chick-fil-A, too. You all even made it through 8 semesters of Dean Sands cooking late night breakfast, and you enjoyed it. And the reason you enjoyed it is because you developed friendships and memories that will last for a lifetime. And when you think about that lifetime, many of you are sitting in this audience and you're pondering what next. Some of you may go off to graduate school, Some are going to work. Some are using OPT. But there are a couple people in here that think their future is unknown. But whenever I was in doubt, I always remembered, if you think you're beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win but think you can't, it's almost a sense you won't. If you think you lose, you're lost, for out in this world you'll find. Success begins with the fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. You got to think how to rise. You got to be sure of yourself before you can ever win a prize. Because life's battles don't always go to the stronger or faster person. But sooner or later, the one who wins is the person who thinks they can. And I think that's so appropriate, Golden Bears, because not only do I think you can, I know you can. I know you can because you are lights that have shined bright over Beckley, West Virginia. And so as we stand here and I think about some things, I challenge you for five things. First, let your light shine. Always stand for something so you don't fall for anything. Continue to put one foot in front of the other. Strive to be better today than you were yesterday. And last but certainly not least, this little Latin phrase I like to use called res non verba, which translates into your deeds, not your words. And so, graduates of the class of 2023, remember tech in all that you do. Remember tech in all that you do, because the one thing that I can guarantee you is that each of you are specks of dust destined to fade like the setting sun. And while none of us may understand when our sun will set, each one of us is blessed to have the opportunity to make the most of every day we witness the sun rise. So class of 2023, it's time for you to rise. It's time for you to go forward. It's time for you to represent the Golden Bears. But more importantly, it's time for you to carpe diem, seize the day. Thank you.
Thank you, President Stewart. At this time, I would like to introduce Mike Fry, class of 1984, and president of the Tech Golden Bear Alumni Association, who will induct the new alumni into the association.
So I'm the strange person that you ran into over there on the side. It's a pleasure to be here today. And it's my honor to get to meet each one of you personally, at least speak to you as you became part of the Alumni Association. As graduates, you have fulfilled requirements for membership into the Alumni Association. We welcome you as full Tech Golden Bear alumni. Just so you know, there are no dues or fees required to be a member. We just ask that you stay connected and engaged so that we can continue to support one another, the future Golden Bears behind you, and our beloved alma mater with your time, your talent, and your treasure. No matter where you go, your Golden Bear family is here for you. Carry your love of West Virginia Tech with you wherever you go, and I promise you it will take you a long way. At this time, I'd like you all to stand, all the graduates and any Tech alumni that are here today. And I will tell you that you are the inaugural class of this new pledge. So the Board of Directors just approved this week, and I'm excited to have the honor of reciting it with you for the first time. So if you'll repeat after me, as a proud graduate of West Virginia Tech, and a member of the Tech Golden Bear Alumni Association, I will serve with honor in my chosen profession and support current and future Golden Bears. I pledge to be of service to others, to my community, and our beloved alma mater. Thank you. Remain standing if you would. It's my pleasure to invite my fellow board of director member, Professor Hillary Purcell, class of 2008, back up to lead us in singing our alma mater.
Congratulations, graduates. Would everyone please remain standing for the recessional?